Guy. Well, last week, Jack Hubley explained that most Pennsylvania bats spend the winter in caves and old mines. In tonight's Wild Moment, he has an update on a devastating disease that has invaded those underground sanctums.
Last week's question from a viewer asking where bats go in the winter reminded me of the crisis facing hibernating bats throughout the Northeast. Most of our Pennsylvania bats hibernate in caves and old mines. But for the past few years, things haven't been going well in the underground, thanks to a disease called white nose syndrome. The disease gets its name from a white fungus that appears on the nose, ears, and wings. Infected bats wake up in the middle of winter and often leave the safety of their caves. Burning precious stored energy, they quickly succumb to exposure and starvation. White nose syndrome was first detected in New York in 2006. Here in Pennsylvania, we've already seen severe declines in bat numbers in the Northeast, and the disease is now spreading to the central and western counties. One of the state's best known bat hibernating sites is an old mine in Blair County's Canoe Creek State Park, where tens of thousands of bats spend the winter. This video, shot by the Pennsylvania Game Commission just last week, shows bats leaving the cave on what will inevitably be their last flight. The Game Commission's bat man, Cal Butchkoski, has counted bats leaving the cave at the rate of 20 to 30 per hour this winter. Until last year, when white nose was first detected here, this cave was a winter home for about 30,000 bats. But Butchkoski expects the deadly fungus to decimate the population.
I'm hoping that we end up with 3,000 after this white nose wave goes through, and management will start all over again.
Until biologists find a way to halt the spread of white nose syndrome, the outlook for Pennsylvania's number one nighttime insect control agents remains grim. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
Well, there are two easy ways you can help bats fight back. If you see bats out during the winter months, the Pennsylvania Game Commission wants to know. You can go to the commission's website and click Report a Sick Bat. And when warm weather finally gets here, consider taking part in a bat count. Information can also be found on the Pennsylvania Game Commission's website. We have a link at WGAL.com.